how to create a very colourful multicoloured stroke in Affinity Designer. So I'm just going to quickly create a shape, any shape design, doesn't matter. Once you've got that, you'll need the appearance panel. So view and studio and appearance. And you'll see you've got here a default appearance. Obviously this one's 80. You can vary it. Simply go over there and click on that and maybe change it down to say 10. So I'm just going to go with 10 for that initial stroke. What I can now do is I can go there and I can right click and I can duplicate. So I'm duplicate that design. And now you see I've got two strokes. Obviously it's not much use. They're both 10 points. So I'm just going to go and make that 20 points. So that one's 20 points. And also what I'm going to do, I'm going to change the color. So I'm just going to go up here and that one there, I can change the color there. You can also change it over here as well. So I'm just going to put that to red. Now at this point you think, oh, well, that's not much use. It's obviously 20 points, 10 points. What you need, the bigger one needs to be just below. So now what you can see, you've got the mustard color one and you've got the red one. Now I can duplicate that one. So again, duplicate. And now I'm just going to go 30 points. So 30 points, set that to that. And now what I can do, I can set that to maybe blue. And you can see what's happening now. I've got this design now all the way around. Now, of course, I could vary the size. That means that could be 20, 40, 60, could be anything. Just a sequence of numbers. Key thing is always make certain that you've got here the settings you want here, the cap and those sort of things. You may find that that doesn't work for every situation. So you'd best set it to that. Also, the key thing for this is the alignment is outside. Very important. Inside, not so useful. Center, not always so. I always find it's probably best to work with stroke on the outside. And that's for all of them. So they're all set with stroke on the outside. So you can see there, cap there, also outside again. So with that, and of course you could add 15, 20. I don't know if there's a limit. However, what you can then do is you can go over here and you've got styles and you can find that in the view menu and studio. And you can go to the right side menu and add style from selection. So add style from selection and then it's just added over there. You can also add other things as well. So you could go over down here to say effects, just down the bottom, and maybe go for 3D. So just add a 3D effect so you get a nice 3D effect as well. Close that and a shadow maybe, up to you. And then you can also go there and add style from selection again. That's still selected, so you've got another style there to work with. And you can remove that now. What you can also do, then you just go here, say like to the pen tool, and I can just quickly add a design, just any design, doesn't particularly, and I can just click there, and you can see what happens. You end up having a nice, colourful design there, and there's the 3D one. Likewise, you can go over here, and let's just go for maybe the brush stroke. So I can just quickly apply a brush stroke very quickly with a mouse. It's not the world's greatest brush stroke. However, you've got that design and then you can simply click there again. And now you've got this 3D design with this lovely design. Now, there's always going to be a slight imperfection there because there's always slight at the ends. Can't do much about that. Well, what you can also do is, oh, key thing here, make certain also the fill, because that is recorded as well. So if you've got a fill that's set to something like a colour, you'll end up with a colour as well. I obviously here didn't have anything there. So that's a key thing. To set that, you just need to go here and set it to that. But you can also then go to maybe a shape as well. So just a shape, any shape. So you've got to select that. I obviously had that earlier, so that's not much use. Let's just go for this one. And you can see the design there. And you can always go over here to the appearance panel and just vary it. So make it 30, 60, 90, etc. And you can also vary the blending mode as well if you want to do that. Of course, once you've got that, what you can then do is you've got this design, you can go Control C or whatever, paste it into Photo, or even better, much better in fact, is go to File and Edit in Photo. If you've got Affinity Photo, that is. If you haven't got Affinity Photo, can't do that. So straight in there and you can see what happens. You've got your design, obviously you've got all of the design now. Don't particularly want that, so I can remove that. But you can see now you've got that design. You can't edit this in here. Not, I mean, you can edit, obviously imply effects and things, but you can't modify. There's no setting for modifying this stroke. So that's, you've just got the red there. It just sees red. Doesn't see anything else. So I click there. There's nothing available there. But what you can do is you can go to filters, say blur, whatever. But of course, when you do that, it becomes a pixel layer. If you don't want to do that, you can always go to layer and new live filter layer, maybe blur that way and Gaussian blur. Apply a quick blur. So you can see you can get a nice blurring effect added to that. Close that. And again, go there and file and gain down to edit in designer. So you can go back to designer and then you've got, now there's slight weird sort of imperfection there. That's just the way it is with the blur, but you can see the effect. So you've got that nice blur effect there and, well, you can even see it over there. So Gaussian blur there. Now I'm not certain actually, and I haven't tried it yet, so I might not do anything. Maybe you can be interested to see if you could actually just go there and then again, add style from selection. Wonder if it saves the effect. No, doesn't do it. Not surprised. That would be odd if it saved the, I thought I might try it just while I was doing that. However, hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.